E-bike tuning. Are you willing to take the risk? Getting more out of your e-bike with e-bike tuning, it sounds tempting, but it's risky and really not a good idea. In this video, you will learn which tuning options are available for e-bikes and why I do not recommend any of them. Did you know that e-bike tuning in France is penalized with up to 1 year in prison and a fine of 30,000 euros? It can also have drastic consequences in Austria or Germany. In this video, you will learn how e-bike tuning works and why I strongly advise against it. PowUnity is an expert in e-bike safety. I'm Matthias from PowUnity, and in this episode, we will discuss the tricky topic of e-bike tuning. If this topic interests you, you have landed on the right channel. Subscribe to the PowUnity channel right here and become part of our powerful community. Before we get into tuning in more detail, let's answer a fundamental question. As you probably already know, e-bike motors are only allowed to be operational up to a speed of 25 kilometers an hour in Austria and Germany. But how does the speed limit on e-bikes actually work? Well, it's simple. E-bike drives measure the speed at which you're cycling and automatically switch off as soon as the maximum speed is reached. How the measurement is carried out depends on the drive. If you have an e-bike with a mid-motor, for example, a sensor measures the speed with the help of a magnet. This method is a gateway for tuning. Hub motors, on the other side, do not need a sensor. In this case, the motor measures the speed directly, which makes tuning more difficult or even impossible. Depending on the e-bike and its drive, you have various options for bypassing the speed limit. Tuning modules, which are attached to the speed sensor of your e-bike, are quite common. Above a certain speed, the module ensures that the sensor only transmits half or a third of the actual speed to the control unit of the drive. One disadvantage of this method is that the values displayed by your bike computer are no longer correct. But if you want to ride your e-bike without the module, you can simply remove it. The removal becomes harder with permanently installed tuning solutions or tuning kits. This group includes the so-called dongles, which function similarly to plug-on chips. Fixed solutions are usually invisible. Many of them also do not falsify the displayed values on your bike computer. In general, most chips or modules do not interfere with the programming of the e-bike drive. Instead, they simulate a slower speed for the motor control. As a result, the motor supports you longer than it should. However, with some tuning kits, you can also increase or remove speed limits completely. Theoretically, you can drive even faster than with a plug-on solution. However, the intervention is more profound and often difficult to undo. Tuning apps usually only work in combination with a tuning module. This allows you to control the tuning on your smartphone and view the central values. Some apps even allow you to change the region to the USA. This gives you more room for maneuver, because in the USA, e-bike motors are allowed to support speeds up to 32 km per hour. As you can see, there are different types of tuning, and I would like to advise against all of them. Not because I'm a boring person, but because there are some solid reasons to stay away from e-bike tuning. One of these reasons are technical risks. E-bike tuning is a thorn in the side of e-bike manufacturers and manufacturers of e-bike motors. This is because tuning increases the risk that the legal regulations for e-bikes will be tightened, which could, of course, have an impact on e-bike demand. In addition, companies often have to deal with dubious warranty claims because of tuning. That's why manufacturers react by, for example, developing drives that compare signals from the speed sensor with other measured values. If there are noticeable deviations, the motor reacts with an error code and restricts the assistance. Apart from that, normal e-bikes are not suitable for constant speeds of 30, 40 or even more kilometers an hour. Even with high-quality e-bikes, tuning leads to higher wear and tear on components such as the drive, gears or brakes. And with cheaper e-bike models, the wear and tear is even greater. Additionally, warranty claims will no longer help you, because no matter which e-bike and which drive you have, tuning voids warranty claims. And please don't get your hopes up that no one will notice anything. A lot of data is stored in the drive of your e-bike, which can be used to find out if the 25 km per hour limit has been exceeded. Tuning also increases the risk of accidents, and if there is an accident at high speed, the consequences are particularly serious. This also applies to the legal consequences. Therefore, you should always keep the following in mind. The maximum limit of 25 km an hour is a condition for not needing a license plate, insurance or driving license as an e-bike rider. The situation is different for a tuned e-bike, as it automatically becomes a moped. This means that if you ride a tuned e-bike, you are riding a vehicle that would need a registration and insurance, but has neither. Many e-bike riders underestimate the consequences. It starts with the fact that you risk heavy fines if you are stopped. No insurance company will pay for any accident damage. If you need medical treatment, you have to pay some or all of the cost yourself, depending on your health insurance. In general, you are liable for accidents with your private assets. If you injure people, you could even be accused of negligent bodily harm and, in the worst case, be sentenced to prison. As you can see, the legislator does not treat e-bike tuning as a trivial offense. And here too, we would like to clear your mind of any illusions. The chances that no one will notice the tuning are almost nil. As a rule, tempering comes to light in accidents at the latest. But of course, you can ride a tuned e-bike in your own courtyard without any problems. Whether that is reason enough for you to use a tuning tool is another question. So, is there no way to legally ride an e-bike faster than 25 km per hour? Actually, there is. You can buy a speed pedelec or S-pedelec for short. These e-bikes have a drive that legally support them up to a maximum of 45 km per hour. However, an S-pedelec needs a license plate and insurance. A helmet is also compulsory and cycle paths are taboo for S-pedelecs. Overall, you can of course optically tune your e-bike without hesitation, as long as this does not affect the functionality of your e-bike. In conclusion, we can say e-bike tuning is tempting. Increasing the performance with a few tweaks and riding your e-bike at a much higher speed at your next tour? Well, that sounds like a lot of fun, of course. But the fun is simply not worth the risk. Because with e-bike tuning, you risk damage to the hardware and technology of your e-bike, serious accidents and high fines, and even a prison sentence. We therefore strongly advise you to refrain from all tuning measures that are not just visual improvements. instead. Enjoy the many possibilities that a normal e-bike offers anyway. If 25 km an hour is too slow for you in the long run, an S-pedelec is a good choice. You can ride it legally and safely at high speeds. Well, that's all I have to say about tuning. Would you like to get more tips on e-bike safety and GPS technology? Then check out our PowUnity Explains topic page. Every week, you will find the information you need to protect your e-bike from theft. You can find the link in the video description down below. Or do you prefer to inform yourself on YouTube? Then subscribe to our channel by clicking on this button. And don't miss any of our PowUnity Explains videos.